Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. We're going to learn how to create condensed structural formulas, which are a method of showing a molecule structure. Condensed structural formulas are often used when you want to show a molecule structure, but you need to write it in a line of text instead of as a picture, like in the Lewis dot structure. Here are our three molecules from our previous video, methane, ethanol, and amphetamine with their Lewis structures. In condensed structural formulas, we write out a non-hydrogen atom, indicate the number of attached hydrogens, and then move to the next non-hydrogen atom. In methane, there is just one non-hydrogen atom, carbon. Write the C for carbon and indicate the number of attached hydrogens, 4. That's it, CH4. In ethanol, we'll start with carbon again. It has 3 hydrogens. The second carbon has 2 hydrogens. Finally, we have the oxygen with 1 hydrogen. Notice that we do not include lone pairs in condensed structural formulas because the dots would be hard to replicate in a text format. The condensed structural formula for amphetamine is kind of tricky. Condensed formulas are written as a line of text. That's fine if your molecule is a linear chain of atoms. Amphetamine is not a line, it has a ring and it has branching. We can handle the branch, but we need to use a shortcut for the ring. Benzene rings are such common features in molecules that there is an abbreviation that people use for it. It is pH and it stands for phenyl. That is an uppercase P and a lowercase H. A phenyl group is a benzene ring dangling off a molecule. Attached to our phenyl group is a carbon with 2 hydrogens. Then we encounter another carbon with 1 hydrogen. Now we've hit our branch point. There are 2 more things attached to this carbon, the last carbon and a nitrogen. Both of those cannot be next in line. In this situation, we'll use parentheses to indicate that we have a branch. Normally, the small group is considered the branch and put in the parentheses. The larger group is then the continuation of the main chain. But both of these groups are fairly similar in size. I'll pick the nitrogen as the branch. The nitrogen, along with its 2 attached hydrogens, go inside the parentheses. We'll close the parentheses to end the branch. The end carbon with its 3 hydrogens finish the structure. We could have written this structure with CH3 as the branch. Yes, the condensed structural formula, it is slightly different, but it is communicating the exact same connectivity in the molecule. Condensed structural formulas are written from left to right, and they should be read from left to right. Condensed structural formulas are a very compact method for communicating molecular structure, but they work best for simpler molecules that do not have features like rings and branching.